Well, we can't solve all of the world's problems in 5 minutes, especially as they seem to be rapidly proliferating. But at least it's important to keep informed, keep the educational process going and developing, keep discussing, keep raising awareness so that someone out there, you know, whoever it may be, will feel motivated and perhaps have a better idea of how to move forward. So we may feel this isn't enough and we're disempowered, or too, you know, more disempowered than we would like to be. But it's better to have a discussion and a session for raising awareness than to, you know, sit back and do nothing. So again, we need to keep these events going. Thank you.
Okay. Sheikh Azmi.
Yeah, well, when we'll talk about things as relates to some of the theoretical arguments, we also, as been related by the speakers, that there is this reality, there is this thing happening on the ground. So I would personally want to, you know, participate in this kind of very high thinking level of understanding why is this happening, where is the source. But together with that, we really have to deal with the ground level where the Muslims have really been suppressed. So I call upon you, this Genocide Memorial Day has to be one of the very important activity, and you have to try to expand this, inshallah. I will do the JMD, inshallah, in Malaysia next year. And we would like to also expound this kind of activities in that corner of the world, inshallah. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Ramon.
Yes, help me with this. What is the name of the journalist of the Independent who covers the Middle East?
Robert Fist,
thank you. I had, you know, a CD that of a conference or he did in the Bay Area in California, and he was talking about how when the Israelis invaded Lebanon in 1982, he was together with a group of Western journalists in a beach of Beirut, and they were standing in the beach, you know, these are, you know, the Western press, you know, and Western journalists, etc. He was together with them covering the entrance of the Israelis, you know, with their tanks to Beirut. And he said that while they were standing there, you know, and seeing the tanks coming and all of that, he saw something that he doesn't have the words to, of course, with the secularists, Westernized language to make sense of it. But in the talk, he started describing what he saw. And what he saw, and all the journalists there were astonished by what they saw. That was 1982. They saw two guys with a green bandana in their head, okay, coming out of the water, running through the sand, and running towards the tanks with pistols this side, the side of their hands, and saying Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, screaming Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, repeating it, and getting close to the tanks, close to them. They were being shot by the Israelis. We saw them coming with and shooting with little guns, okay? They got to the tanks, to one of them. The Western press were like, who the hell are these crazy people? I mean, that's the only word they have to describe this, because they have no words to really make sense of what they were seeing. These guys went over the fire, got to a tank, opened the tank, killed the Israeli guy, took the body out, got into the tank and moving around and start attacking the Israelis with the tank. This was the first military act of Hezbollah. 20 years later, they kicked the Israeli out of Lebanon. Okay, so look at this, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, how in a moment of the most desperate moment, the most devastating moment, these people uplifted themselves from the bottom and managed to pull out a movement that kicked out the Israelis from Lebanon soil. That's an example of, I think, what the Ummah should be doing today in terms of these intra-dialogues, that as difficult as it looks, as impossible as it looks, there cannot be more impossible than kicking the Israeli army from Lebanon. And they did it. So you can do it too. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you to all the speakers. Thank you all so much for your enlightening.